Greetings, everybody. So yeah, pipes. I really love this pipe. This one's the Londoner one. It's, I don't know, it's just beautiful. It's got a nice large bowl. And this is another pipe I use a lot. It's some French pipe, apparently. And it's got a stinger in it. Not a wasp, a stinger. See that bit of metal, you see that? It's shitted up there a little bit. But kind of a metal filter. And it takes up the moisture. When you're smoking, you get like moisture in the bowl here, and it so it stops it dribbling down your throat. Remember years ago I was fishing, I was about 20 years old, and I had one of my dad's pipes, and he didn't have anything like that. And I used to take a pipe fishing to keep warm. Wow. Every time you light it up, you get a bite. But when one day I was throwing that out, I got a mouthful of this dribbly, tarry, horrible brown stuff straight down my throat. So I try and smoke a pipe with a filter now. Yeah, so you're not bubbling sound. That's it, that's that kind of thing. But I need to find the right size filter for this. Well, you can make filters apparently. Just roll up a bit of paper and shove it down in here. Anyway, enough of that. Here's a quick joke. This old bloke lives in his shack. It's really cold winter. Snow's on the ground, and he's sat in front of his fire, smoking his Missouri corn cob with Black Irish Twist. Really horrible strong tobacco. Keeping nice and warm. And here's this tap on the window. What the bloody hell's that? So goes out, he has a look at the window, opens it. Can't see anything, just snow coming down. Anyway, so he shuts the window. And about 10 minutes later, there's this scratching on the door. And it's next door's cat, and it's freezing. He's a poor bugger. So he lets it in, and sits on his lap. Anyway, half an hour later, there's this tapping at the door again. Bloody hell, he's quite happy trying. He's going to have to relight his pipe now. He's just farting around going to the door. So he opens the door. All he can see is the snow coming down. And can't see anything. About to shut the door. Here's his voice. Excuse me, mister. Excuse me, mister. He's looking around. Please, will you let me in? I'm cold. He's looking around, can't see anything, and it, please mister. So he looks down, and there's this snail there, about that big. He's looking at it, up at him. Please mister, I'm freezing, will you let me in? He's sat up. So he gets his size 9 Doc Martens, levers it, gives you the right boot. Snail goes straight down to the bottom of the garden. It's right, anyway. So shuts the door, sits there with a cat. Anyway, about 3 weeks later, still having a really crap winter, scratching at the door. It's the cat again. Lets it in, shuts the door, sparks up his corn cob again with the Black Irish Twist tobacco, which is it's like chewing tobacco, it's horrible. That stuff Clint Eastwood spat out in that film, The Outlaw Josie Wales. Anyway, sits down. Next minute, tap, tap, tap on the window. It's what, dappling up, what's going on? Can't see anything. Sits down with a cat, cat's purring. Black Irish twisting his Missouri corn cob. Anyway, then the tap, 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 scratch on the door. Flipping out. Gets up, goes to the door. Excuse me, mister. Look down, his snail says, what you do that for?
Just got back from doing my shopping now, so the freezer's full, so I've got plenty to eat for the rest of the week. But on my way back, I was just thinking about a funny story that happened to me when I was at the airport. I don't know if you know me or if you've heard of me. Well, you probably haven't, because it's a news thing. But anyway, I worked at Manchester Airport for about 20-odd years. Hang on. On any road, we were turning around this Lufthansa A320. And granted, it was taking a long time. Various reasons that are of absolute no interest to you at all. But the pilot got pissy. He was a young pilot, mid to early 20s. Bit of bumfluff, you know the sort, you know, arrogant bastard. Not a very nice person at all. And he comes down and he says to our dispatcher, he says, what's going on? He says, I have been on the ground here for many, many minutes. He says, I am likely to miss my slot for takeoff. And our dispatcher says to him, he says, look, sir, of course, obviously, you have to give them a bit of respect because they are pilots after all, glorified bus drivers, but you don't tell them that, they get upset. Anyway, he says, I'm very sorry, but we've had a few problems with your turnaround. We'll get you off we'll get you off, you know, as soon as we can. Anyhow, this upstart of a pilot, he was a young lad, this was what made it so galling. He says, you English, you could learn from some German efficiency. And learn to turn your aircraft around in short space of time. Anyhow, our dispatcher, he looked at him, he said, you know, sir, you're right, absolutely right, I agree with you 100%. As a matter of fact, me dad used to be a pilot, and he said the turnaround times in Berlin were second to none. And this pilot says, your father threw aircraft? And the dispatcher said, yeah, Lancasters.